I've actually been following Aces basketball probably a little closer for better part of 15, almost 20 years. We always knew about the sleeves growing up being a college basketball fan. So the tragedy just really defined our basketball program.
I was 13 days old when the tragedy happened. Having worked at the university for over 20 years, I've seen the impact that it has had on the community. That team was very special because that was the very first Division I team. And there were a lot of local players. And you can tell that when the crash happened and those young men perished, that it really left a big scar on the community of Evansville. And it's something still that I don't think the city and the tri-state area has fully gotten over, even though it's almost 50 years since the tragedy.
There was so much transition. You know, the school had just gone Division I, so that really kind of marked a big benchmark. Of course, we have the physical remembrances on campus, and every year as the athletic director in the basketball program, we have to make sure that we remember all those people that passed away and do that correctly in order to really honor their passing and the history and what they meant to the program. But just like, you know, Marshall has their plane crash, it's something that we every year have to remember and be very mindful of.
You hear about the history back in the days with Hugh Ollering, Jerry Sloan, Don Boozy, you know, just so many of the great players, and Coach Arad McCutcheon. Since I've been here, we had our top two leading scorers in program history played here with Colt Ryan and DJ Ballantyne breaking the records, and Agidius Miscavichus breaking the rebound record.
DJ Ballantyne and Agidius Miscavichus, I think that those two guys, especially in tandem, were an incredible pair to see Agidius really develop into the dominant big man in the Valley, to see them both be first team all-conference, and to see DJ do the kind of scoring that he did. A team that had five double-digit scorers, you know, all the way across the starting line, and really played well as a team.
The players are tremendous role models. I have an 11-year-old son. He looks up to the Aces players. They're idols to him. They're guys who are bigger than life, and I think every guy who's gone through that program has really left an imprint on the young kids in the Evansville community.
A lot of our supporters may not be alumni. They may be fans in the community. Going back to the 60s, I'd say people in Evansville viewed the Purple Aces as their professional team.
UE basketball, you know, is on the national stage. You know, we had a chance, you know, last year in beating the University of Kentucky, and everyone across the country and probably the world knew that we beat UK. We have the ability to bring outside eyes to what's going on in this part of the country, and you know, we take that very seriously. So, you know, we recruit kids and coaches that represent our university well.
The job that they do giving back to the community, I think it's priceless. I don't think you can put a dollar amount on that.